Hello, everyone, and welcome back to Star Trek Online, where I'm approaching the Eldrin system, and we are going to pick up the mission at Eldrin 4, Entering the Shadow, or In the Shadow of Cestus. I think the whole mission is... Oh, In the Shadow of Cestus is the whole mission. Entering the Shadow is this phase of it. There will be many phases. Alright, Tarsi says, Lieutenant, we are reading several Gorn ships on our sensors, as well as the USS Zhanghe. Zhanghe is hailing us now, okay?
Welcome to Eldrin 4.
Captain McKinnon.
CO of the USS Zhanghe. Glad you could join
Zhanghe.
Us.
Zhanghe, okay.
My science teams are on site and conducting initial surveys. Apparently, this place is quite the geological marvel. We're not the only ones present, though. Our friends from the Gorn hegemony aren't terribly chatty, but so far they're keeping the peace.
Alright, how can we help?
Well, I'm sure my people wouldn't mind an extra hand down there on the geological marvel. Feel free to join the party.
She doesn't sound too interested in the geological marvel herself. It's sort of somewhat sarcastic, it feels. But okay, I'll send a team down to the surface. Gorn are scanning us. They might not be talkative, but they're curious. Well, just steady as she goes. Yes. Caution when dealing with the Gorn. She recommends caution. Well, she is our tactical officer. Tactical officers always recommend caution, don't they? You would think so. Makar Frigate Kulshedra Battleship. Oh, I should purchase my skills and do that sort of thing, huh? I have skill points to distribute here. Hull restoration?
Transporter room to bridge. The geological team, supplies, and gear are ready to beam down to Eldrin 4.
Alright. Yeah, let's beam down and then handle all the skill points. Unusual energy signatures in orbital space near Eldrin 4. Recommend we perform a deep scan of each. Could be hazardous. Oh, okay, so I'm not going down with the way team. Alright. Okay, bring us into sensor range. I think hull restoration, hull capacity. It all seems very important. Start with shield restoration. Okay, purchase. Yeah, sure. And then, I guess, this ground skill. We have one ground skill point. This is totally different from the way skill points were distributed like a year ago. Or maybe in the rest of the game, maybe this is just in the 23rd century tech tree, if you will. Weapon proficiency, endurance training. Weapon proficiency, yeah, I think so. You can retrain skills here. Alright. That's good, because I have no idea what I'm doing. Traits for my Vulcan here. Mind meld, ooh. Oh, I must have mind meld. Bulkhead technician. Not crippling can I deselect this? Doesn't seem like I can distribute them. Oh, traits can only be activated and deactivated while in a social zone. Okay. So, I'll have to think about that. So far, we'll just have to make do with the ones we got by default. Tarsi's our only officer. Okay. Perform orbital scan. Strange, what have you got? An impulse drive? False alarm? No, it's there. I guarantee it's there. They made it to the surface and made contact with the science team from the Zhanghe. And the rest of the landing party is staying by in transporter room 1. Okay, now I get to go down. Alright.
During missions, you can select
just
the
me and Tarsi.
Alright.
Well, not much to select for the away team selection screen.
Ah, there you are. never, huh? Ensign Scavrin, Starfleet Corps of Engineers. Lovely planet we've got here. Charming, even, if you're fond of heat and rocks. Still, it's not a complete wash. To say this place is mineral-rich would be an understatement.
Ooh, time to get mining. Sounds exciting.
You can find mission objectives on your mini-map, or by pressing the...
Okay, take mineral scans. Is there dilithium? I could do with more dilithium. Incidentally, it's worth looking at our inventory. We don't have much by way of inventory. There's limited inventory slots. I mean, it's quite a lot of space. But if you want, you can buy more slots with Zen. R&D and then assets. So if we take a look at assets, I think we're going to get some dilithium from this mission. And then we need to refine it in order to get that. And then there's the dilithium store here with special items and boxes and such. EV suits. And then this Zen. If you wanted to convert... Ooh. If you wanted to convert dilithium to Zen, there's this dilithium exchange. Dilithium this exchange. Oh, there we go. Phew. I was wondering what the heck dilithium exchange is disabled. Wow, that's expensive. One Zen for 400? I swear, I thought it was less than 200 before. Inflation. Okay. So where do I go first?
Showing some interesting mineral formations beyond this ridge.
It's a nice world. Where's the map on our... Okay, guess over there. Yep, there's the
this
colored
looks like
rocks.
A good place to start our scans.
Yeah, because it's glowing.
Nice to see a report was spot on for once. The mineral deposits here are remarkably pure.
But what kind of mineral?
This carbon deposit is unusually pure. Apparently,
carbon.
Electrons don't prepare.
Carbon is not that rare. I mean, can you be more specific? What kind of carbon? Are we talking about diamonds here? Are diamonds even useful? Like, I guess diamonds are always useful. Seems like we'll have to go around here.
Whoever gets the mineral rights to this planet will be pleased. Very pleased indeed.
They're mine. They're all mine.
My readings indicate there might be dilithium.
Dilithium, there we go. Now you're talking.
More scans to be sure.
Now you're talking. And after saying that, the Gorn appear, right?
The variety of minerals in the topsoil alone is astounding.
I feel like I'm getting led somewhere. Yeah, well, there's a bigger circle up front here.
Either my tricorder is broken.
Sulfur?
Soil here has an amazingly high concentration of sulfur.
Yeah, my nose told me that long before your tricorder. And I didn't realize, well, I guess sulfur is important, but I don't want any part of it. There's some red dots back there.
A mortar fire? We gotta head back to... Whoa! The mortars have closed off the pass. We can't reach the camp. Who would do this?
Look, one guess. There.
It's the Gorn.
The Gorn. No! Okay. Oh! Rock throwing Gorn. Heavy boulders do a surprisingly low amount of damage. The Gorn don't seem to pack shields, huh? Feel the power of my beam rifle. One of the Gorn ships just exploded? They're blaming us and attacking our forces on the surface and in orbit. Captain McKinnon tried to explain, but they aren't responding to any hails. We're defending ourselves and the fireman's shields are up, which means we can't beam you back to the ship. Okay, well,
over
we'll have
there.
To find our own way back
there might
then.
Be a way out of this infernal canyon further down the valley.
Further down. Oh, there's some Gorn. Yeah, I got range on you guys. Oh, wait. I remember the mortar, so we gotta watch out for that. Alright. You couldn't throw that rock before I killed you. Oh, and you can take items. They sometimes drop stuff. Small shield charges.
We need a way out of this canyon. And I'm thinking that big rock up there is it. With a little Federation ingenuity, we can topple this rock with a makeshift bomb. Once it's down, we can walk across it and get back to camp before the Gorn use the Zhonghas science team as target practice.
Okay, where do we get this bomb from? Okay, well, let me take items.
Captain Kirk's report on this place. We have all the materials we need here to make bombs. They won't be pretty like me, but they'll get results. If you can collect the materials, Ensign Hunter and I will work out where to place the explosives.
Okay, we need...
We're going to need at least 3 bamboo containers, sulfur, potassium nitrate, and coal.
Okay, behind interesting. Us. Lessons in bomb making here. Very good. Okay, don't forget our items. Okay, so I am being led in this direction. And what do we have here? There we go, collecting coal. Very old tech, but we're not burning coal, we're exploding it. So that's good. You almost feel sad for the enemies. The Gorn in this case. Okay, collecting sulfur. They had to make me collect sulfur. And which one is this? Potassium nitrate. Okay, so then all that's left is the bamboo containers. Why bamboo? How can it be? We must have. Well, no, there's really bamboo here. Okay, how can this be a new world and have bamboo? Maybe it's just a plant that looks like bamboo and they called it bamboo because it looks like bamboo. Perhaps bamboo-like things are relatively common in the universe. Just like a natural type of life form to occur. Heavy Ranger. Well, doesn't seem any tougher than the others, so maybe that's just a reflection of his weight. Or ability to throw rocks. Ouch. That did surprisingly little damage. They really need to get better rocks. That was hard to spot. Okay, so we've got all the things. Let's make an explosive to do damage to the landscape in order to get home.
Right. Ensign Hunter and I will construct the bombs we need to bring down this rock across the canyon. That's the easy part. It's up to you to keep those angry Gorn off us while we work. Hope you're a good shot.
Yes, I am. Okay.
Crush that coal up good, Hunter. Not like that, finer.
The Gorn were just sort of standing there.
Careful with that.
I think Tarsi is a bomb thrower, that's good. I mean, one of those people with grenades or mortars or something. I wonder if I have grenades.
Now mix it with the coal. Carefully. I'd rather not get blown to pieces.
I mean, I'm a tactical officer too. I must have some skills.
We're just about done.
Well, cardiopulmonary resuscitation is sort of important.
Now let's get these bombs in place.
Okie dokie. Alright, this seems dangerous. Okay, place charge. I hope you got a good timer for this stuff.
The bombs are primed to blow. We should move to a safe distance.
Okay, where would that be? Looks like in this direction. Right there. Okay, right here. This is the safe location.
Fire in the hole!
Oh, that's what he was trying to do. Make a ramp? I get it. My jumping ability is a little bit weak. Okay, it looks like in this direction. This is a pretty serious wall here.
Looks like some Gorn came through here. We better hurry.
They really fortified their camp. But to no avail against the Gorn. So. Ouch. Yeah, definitely up the damage from those rocks, darn it. Okay, we have to talk to... lead scientist. Yes.
Thank you. Things were looking pretty grim there for a moment.
Dr. Ward.
The Gorn. They kept saying the deaths of their people would be avenged, but we didn't do anything. I haven't fired a phaser since the Academy.
You're safe now, Doctor. Just join your people on the shuttle and head back to your ship. Okay, beam us up, but I don't sense that this is gonna be the end of this. Those who are about to die, okay. Saluting the Zhang He. Okay.
Good to hear from you. Thank you for saving my people. We're making repairs, but it'll be some.
Oh, there's a thingamajig up there. Oh, that's the Zhang He. Maybe spewing out some stuff. Eventually, in systems, there will be stuff to scan and for resources. Part of the in-game economy.
We're picking up Gorn warp signatures on our long-range sensors here. They're coming back!
Okay, yes. Put us between... okay, yes. Fire all the things.
You can fire all weapons at once by pressing the space bar.
Yeah. That's supposed to be what's happening. I think I need more forward shields here. They only have forward shields. That's interesting. And they also have weapons that can pass right through our shields, judging from our hull strength. Or they do have rear shields, but not side shields. Wow. Heavy high yield torpedo launched. Very good. They're serious. These Gorn are tough. I mean, on the ground they're not tough, but their ships are tougher than the ones we saw in the previous battles. Any captain skills I could use? Not much, I need an engineer. Okay. That's still a tight battle between us and them. Those explosions from. Oops. That high yield torpedo probably just slammed into their shields. Warped away and left us an explosion. That's not fair. Okay, apparently next is answer to heal. Ah, there
us.
We go.
The Gorn would have made slow but steady. Our warp drive is still disabled, but we're making progress.
Well, here are some spare supplies. Yep.
Thanks. I hate to ask, but something's bothering me. We picked up strange energy readings before the attack. It could be nothing.
Alright, give us
now.
Your data.
I'd start with the debris of the Gorn ship that was destroyed. There might be a clue there.
Got it. Saluting the Gorn. I don't understand the saluting thing. Those who are about to die worries me. Okay, investigate debris.
The crew of the Shangha were onto something. I ran a deep scan analysis of the Gorn debris, and the results are damn peculiar.
Go on.
Gorn ships aren't as tough as a Tellarite design, but our scaly friends know a thing or two about hull plate. Whoever fired this shot knew exactly where to hit them.
Okay, can you tell who did it?
With the data we have now, but the science team just found another strange energy reading nearby.
All right, that sounds dangerous, but that's what we're here for. Strange anomaly. Looks like a little black hole right there. It's sucking some stuff in. Don't feel too good about this. Yeah, this looks like a mini, we'll call it a singularity? Singularity? Yep.
Picking up debris from the Gorn ship and some trace elements of weapons-grade plasma. Sir, I know who did this. It's the Romulans.
Romulans? Are you sure?
I'll shave my eyebrows if I'm wrong. It's the Romulans. I'm sure of it. There's more bad news. The Gorn are coming back. Weapons hot. Orders?
Red alert! Okay, well, at least our hull has. Well, let's not go into the black hole or anything. No mention of it being a black hole, just plasma, huh? Weird. Ouch. Ouch. Turning hard. Wonder if there's any countermeasure for those things. Possibly evasive maneuvers? I don't know. Thank you. Possibly this wouldn't be so hard if I just hit it from the side where there's no shields. Well, we got them down to 28%, 27%, and are they done for? Just seemed like they were done for. Let's hail them. Can we hail them?
We thought we could share this space equally, Federation. Your unprovoked act of aggression against our research vessel tells me otherwise.
Yeah. It was Romulans, buddy.
I see no Romulans. Only Federation ships. Do you think me a fool, Captain?
Here's the data.
Most convenient, Captain. But I am unconvinced. Produce these Romulans that you claim destroyed our ship, or prepare to pay for your crime.
I don't think he fully appreciates the situation that he's in, but okay.
Captain, I've got an idea. If we can generate a charged particle burst, we might overload their cloak.
Sounds good. Make it happen. Reveal the Romulans. Pretty silly cloaking devices if it's that easy, right? But whatever. Okay.
Quite a clever one, Captain. Too clever, I'm afraid.
Wasn't my idea.
No one can know of our actions here today. Your death are regrettable.
Maybe I'm also part Romulan, I don't know. Anyway, we'll see about that. No, Vulcan and Klingon, that's all. Well, I really don't know what to say about the battles. I mean, these early battles, there's not much to comment on. There isn't too much sophisticated going on here. Not using a bewildering array of abilities or anything. The only special ability I really have is the high yield torpedo from Tarsi. Well, we might as well toss one in there. Now that the shield is... Oh, I was hoping that the shield would be down on that side when the torpedo went, but okay. Not too bad. Okay, well, take items. Could be something good. No, just a weapon battery. Weapon batteries are a dime a dozen. Yeah, space combat in general in this game is definitely more involved and takes a bit more time than the ground combat. Alright, Gorn ships, talk to me.
Well fought, Federation. The Hegemony will remember the Romulan treachery today, and your assistance in exposing it. I propose we continue our joint surveys of Edrin IV under a mutual non-aggression pact.
If I trust him, okay.
So there was another player on the field. Nice work out there, Captain. We'll be heading for the closest starbase soon, but we'll be back to finish our work here, along with the Gorn, I'll wager. I think the Romulans will take a pass, though.
And with good reason. Good luck, Captain. Alright. Warp 3 out of the system. Oop, sudden explosion. Totally random explosion.
Most missions can be turned in remotely. Click the icon next to the mission to report to the contact and turn in the mission.
Good to hear from you. I've read Captain McKinnon's report. Sounds like things got a little rough on Edrin IV. Still, the diplomatic corps thinks your actions will make a difference in future talks with the Gorn. Well done.
Okay, experience points, expertise. Scavrin, who was the Tellarite engineer, we get him on board, I guess. Type 3 phaser rifle Mark II, which appears definitely better than my current laser rifle. Phaser rifle, sorry. and the dilithium ore. Okay.
Stay safe out there.
Okay, I'll just keep his uniform as is. Scavern is a fine name. Okay, let's try the next mission.
Starfleet hasn't heard from Deep Space Station K-13 in a while. It's in a tactically sensitive part of the quadrant, and the brass is getting concerned. Get out there, find out what you can, and render assistance if needed. And hey, be careful, okay? This could go sideways fast.
Go sideways. And then we get a science officer from this mission, so then we'll finally have a proper crew. And we'll have a upgraded torpedo launcher, warp core, personal shield, and more dilithium. So, this is a good deal. Let's proceed. Where is this? It's in the Orion sector. Oh dear. Okay. Okay, well, it looks like we have another space skill point to distribute. Well, I think I'm gonna go with tactical skills, so energy weapon training, first and foremost. Let's get that. Alright. Okay, proceeding on. We can do a lot of business while we're en route to different places. But I'm going the wrong way here. There we go. There is also the matter of leveling up our officers, which has changed somewhat over time. Okay, Deep Space K-13. Here we go. Begin Painful Omens. Okay, we've arrived near Deep Space K-13. This is odd, not picking up any comm traffic, no signals, nothing at all. Scan for signs of enemy ships or activity. No, none of that, no combat. Okay, yellow alert, prepare for approach. Can we scan for life forms? I mean, is there anybody still alive on K-13? You know, it says Myrmidon over there. Uh-oh. Other ships are raising their shields. What? Charging weapons? What's this? No. I've already got them on auto fire. It's all right. That's another Pioneer class one. The Myrmidon, I don't know what kind it is. But there are enemies. Why? So the engineer has this engineering team that allows hit point restoration on the fly, which is good. We may need that. Alright, looks like we're doing well. Yes, that one's done. Myrmidon? Okay, let's try for high yield. We're on the wrong side here. Okay, that was good. Yeah. That was a good shot with the high yield torpedoes. And that's that one. Except we're still shooting at it. No, don't need to do that. Okay, now what? Well, there's a star base. Yeah, they were Starfleet ships assigned to patrol the sector. Yep. Don't think that was war game. Nope. See if you can raise any of the ships. Use all channels. Open hailing frequencies.
They're taking control. Don't come near us. They'll take you too.
Uh-oh.
The station.
Okay, who's taking control? We're to investigate the situation immediately. Mention the station. This seems like a bad idea. Yeah, let's scan from a nice distance, shall we? No signs of combat on board the station, no hostile lifeform readings, everything's quiet. Sensors are picking up a number of life signs over there, but not reading any unusual activity. All of the station systems seem to be functioning normally. Ew, boy. Okay, let's go over there. And I'll just take my normal peoples. No one's at their duty stations? Yeah, I'm not surprised. Not even a transporter operator. Station's not on alert. Picking up a life sign. Okay, set phasers to stun. Can I set my phaser to stun? I'll just have to hope that my phaser's on stun. They're all red on the map. It says they're all red. Okay. Those blast points in the wall are from phaser fire. Yeah, there was a fight. I've got a bad feeling about this. Oh, yes. Okay, that's not a way to go. Sick bay. Oh, we have to look at the medical officer.
Stop where you are and turn about slowly. I need to determine if you are infected.
Infected with what exactly?
Neural parasites. A life form last encountered by the crew of the Enterprise at Deneva Colony. Those possessed by the creatures tend to engage in hostilities with the uninfected, the better to render them fit for infestation.
Okay, I think I remember that one. Are we going to be following in the footsteps of the Enterprise all the way through these missions? We'll see.
Temet, and while you have not engaged in hostilities thus far, I have seen infected employ false passivity in order to lure unwary prey. A tricorder scan of your adrenaline levels should verify your status.
A logical precaution. A logical precaution, Ensign. Scan away.
Scans show a slightly elevated level of adrenaline, though nowhere near that of an infected life form. Thank you for your patience. One can never be too cautious where these parasites are concerned. According to Starfleet data files, the parasites can be safely destroyed by exposure to high-intensity ultraviolet light. My attempts at reconfiguring the station's lighting thus far have been unsuccessful. I am a physician, not a habitat engineer.
You're a doctor, not an engineer. Got it.
As a precaution, I have developed a serum that can render a person toxic to the creatures. However, medical supplies here are limited. I have enough serum to inoculate your landing party and one other person.
Okay, inoculation sounds good for now. We'll have to find that one other person. Okay, use comm system. Okay, anyone able to respond?
I wasn't expecting.
Hey, Scotty!
You heard my distress call then. Well, in case you haven't noticed, the station's been overrun by neural parasites. Devils are back with a vengeance.
Okay, we're safe up in sickbay. Can you join us?
I'm afraid not. I'm in the auxiliary control room, down on the engineering deck. The place is filthy with parasites, so you'll understand if I don't go out for a wee jaunt.
Okay, well, we'll make our way there.
I have secured a small amount of security gear. It may give you another edge against the parasites.
Okay, let's go. Security gear. Take all, and let's equip. So, inventory. That's no good. But, energy dampening on. Oh, there's a Type 3 phaser rifle. Okay, I want that. Pretty good. And I will take the energy dampening armor Mark II for myself. Yes. Yeah. No biggie. Scavron. Well, yeah, there's two Mark I's, so that's fine. Tarsi. Oh, I thought the science officer was going to join us. Not so far, apparently. And I get a shield upgrade for myself. Yep. hypos we've got. I'll take the small shield recharges. Okay, I think we're all set. Got my rifle and everything, but I don't need it showing up on my back, really. There we go. Oh. Ooh. They're into melee, apparently. Okay, well, let's shoot them first and then scan later, shall we? Okay. What was she about to say? Okay, let's make sure we're not in combat. Okay, now scan infected.
The creatures continue to be resistant to tricorder scans, sir. It may be fascinating.
Tachyons.
I'm detecting an unusually high level of tachyons nearby. Based on these readings, it is possible that a temporal event
has occurred on the station
within the last 4.2 hours.
Fascinating. Yes. Very fascinating. I smelled this one coming. When all the crew of the Enterprise said they recognized us. Who's shooting at who? Oh, there we go. Alright. On to the turbo lift. Alright. Let's rescue Scotty.
The auxiliary control station is down the hall to our right.
Got it. Okay.
It's good to see a friendly
face. I thought it was to our right. Okay.
There you are. I was beginning to get a bit concerned. Thought you might have been taken by those little beasties. I'll just lock the door so none of them can get in while we discuss our next course of action. Now that you're here, we've some work to do. The way I see it, we need to get to main engineering and turn on the station's ultraviolet lighting. That'll sort the nasty buggers out properly.
Okay.
While I cannot attest to the ability of UV light to sort Denovan parasites, it will initiate a complete molecular breakdown within all parasites exposed to it.
I don't understand the distinction here. The ability of UV light to sort Denovan parasites?
She's a Vulcan, all right.
Okay, maybe she was taking things too literally.
It looks like someone sabotaged several duotronic relays. We have to repair them if we're going to have any chance of saving the station. Before we go, grab yourself a kit from the crate there. It might come in handy. We better get a move on. The parasites aren't ones to loiter about.
Alright. Glad you're with us. And we can't go out that door. Alright. Take kit from crate. Tactical
kit. A kit to gain new ground combat abilities.
Aye, this is one of the broken relays, right here.
Okay. Kit confirmed.
That one was easy. Just a few more to go.
Footwell.
Several ways through the engineering section here. Keep in mind that the parasites tend to stay in dark corners. If you want to avoid them, do your best to stay in the lit areas.
Alright, let me get the photon grenade here. Oh, I get it. I'm held, no! Stop pulling me, no! Tarsi, help! Okay.
Remember, the parasites like the dark. We devils that they are.
Our odds of success are greatest if we remain in well-lit areas.
Okay, well-lit areas. Well, this is well-lit here. Okay. So this
may be a bit tricky.
All right, repairing a relay. Let's shoot all the bad things.
Just a wee bit. There we are.
Okay, hopefully Scotty is doing something important, because I don't see him anywhere. Oh, there he is. Uh-oh, no! Okay, he's saved himself from the... No, he's not. They're very resilient, these creatures. Stop it. Okay, let's go on. Where is the last geotronic relay?
This one just needs new fuses.
Oh, he's found it. Oh, and there is a neuroparasite. Oh, Scotty.
There we are. Good as new.
Alright. Back to main engineering. Oh, wait. Uh-oh. Okay. I'm free. Engineering, please. Activate station UV lighting. There we go. Oh wow, lots of the little critters.
It looks like someone has overridden the command codes. You best get to the command center and see what you can do from there. I'll stay here, barricade the door, and keep trying to get those UV lights going.
Alright. So yeah. This is no longer our target location. We should be going on to the bridge, right? Jeffrey's tube to the command center, okay. So, tube, yes. Okay, on to the command center.
Look.
Uh-oh.
Who are those soldiers?
That's
definitely not Starfleet.
That guy looks like Starfleet. Who? What? Which soldiers? If it's just this person, I can't figure out how she knew this person wasn't Starfleet. Oh, maybe through the window there. Ouch. Wow, I'm almost dead. I'm incapacitated is what happened. Respawn. Okay, that was my first incapacitation. That's weird. Space Commander is pretty tough. Who are you guys? Hold on, I want to take a look. Romulans? Blop, blop. Blop. Get baked.
The parasites. They're dying. All of them.
Salvage what you can and send a squad to kill the Federation vermin.
Okay. Alien intruder. All right, we'll take that. Well, that was a heck of a squad you sent. That was a bunch of crack troops right there. We need to talk? Okay, Hunter, what do you want? I was expecting this. I was wondering about this Hunter guy all along.
Actually, the name's
Daniels. Uh-huh. Yeah, you look
this
like Daniels.
This may be a little difficult to absorb, but recent events may make it more plausible. I'm actually from the future.
No, I saw Enterprise. I know.
I can't tell you how far. Just that it's a future worth protecting. That's why I'm here now. The aliens we're fighting are called the Nakul.
Nakul.
Cold War with us. They're trying to change the timeline here in order to disrupt the future. Understand that I follow a temporal version of the Prime Directive. There's only so much I can reveal to you. Trust that we're doing the right thing here.
Time's a factor. Yeah, we'll see about that.
We need to stop the Nakul from obtaining the neural parasites. The Nakul ship that brought these invaders is now fighting the USS Ptolemy.
Okay, do they
Someone
win?
Someone must have sent a distress call. Unfortunately, Ptolemy is no match for the Nakul. Neither is your ship, at least not alone. We should eliminate the parasites on the ships you fought earlier. Those crews will help you once their minds are their own again. It's risky, but it's our best shot here.
Okay. Alright, we'll return to our ship. Okay, Tommy is holding off the Nakul.
I'm transferring command codes to you now. Use them to remotely access the computer on those disabled ships and emit an ultraviolet flash inside.
Okay, thank you.
This is Captain Serralt of the Ptolemy. We have engaged the enemy ship, but we are outmatched.
Yep, we're trying to revive some help here.
Please restore those ships and join the fight quickly.
Glad to know you are aware of our plans. Flash ships with ultraviolet light.
That did it, Captain. Looks like everyone's coming around. The parasites are gone.
This is Captain Doherty of the USS Myrmidon. What happened?
You're lucky What's to be alive, on? Buddy. Okay, neuroparasites. There you go.
Okay, sorry. We're right behind you, Captain. Lead the way.
Good job. Let us not waste any time.
We're not doing any damage.
The Ptolemy has been destroyed. They have some kind of temporal shielding.
Temporal shielding. Daniel sounds surprised by this. Is it? Okay, it is. Alright, so now we can fight him, right? Right? Right. Okay. Fire all the guns. Okay, I just want to lob a torpedo on the open shield side right there. That was a misfire. Tarsi, come on! Oh, something happened. We, did something. I don't know if we disabled it, destroyed it, or it got away. Looks like one of those black hole thingamajigs, actually.
You sent those devils back to wherever they came from.
Is that what we did?
The burst I sent, when combined with the power source, created a feedback pulse. The feedback is creating some kind of spatial anomaly, which is beginning to pull the station in. We need to evacuate.
Uh-oh, anomalies. I hope they're not the type of anomaly that can grow, right? I mean, because growing anomalies, we know, eventually swallow the galaxy and the universe and something like that. Yeah, let's evacuate the station. Let's hope it's just a stable temporal anomaly.
The portal's collapsing. We're in for a right bumpy ride.
Oh, it's collapsing. Okay, good.
Everyone's aboard. Get us clear before that portal blows.
Oh, I guess he's in charge.
There she goes. I don't think anyone's ever seen a station do that.
Okay, are we gonna see that station again in some other time frame? Maybe? Few distress signals from inside the station? Aw, we missed some
Perhaps
peoples.
No. After all, it was a temporal vortex.
Okay. Fair enough.
Well then, it's been quite a day, hasn't it? Neural parasites. Time's ravening raiders. Why, things will seem almost normal once I'm back on the Enterprise. Speaking of, I'm sure one of the ships here can give me a lift back to her now that they're parasite-free. If Starfleet Command gives you any grief on this, remind them that lives are more valuable than equipment. And you saved a lot of lives today.
Thanks, Scotty. Give my regards.
I apologize for springing all of this on you at the last minute. And I'll explain more as soon as I
last
can.
Last minute.
For now, I can tell you that history is unfolding as it should, and that was not the end of K-13. You're building a fine tradition of making the right decisions in crisis situations. In the meantime, don't talk to anyone about the Nakul or their time travel. We can't risk any further corruption of the timeline.
Okay, I don't know who else would believe me without some more evidence, so alright. System scans clear, looks like everything's getting back to normal. Alright, so we'll conclude this here, and we'll report back to Starfleet about our mission. Okay.
Let me get this straight. K-13, an entire space station, just disappeared into some type of spatial anomaly? And I thought some of Kirk's after-action reports were a little out there. Starfleet Command won't be pleased with the loss of K-13, or the people that were still on board, but they'll be happy to hear about the lives you did save. Good work out there. Keep it up.
Alright, experience points, expertise, Temet as our science officer, and the other goodies. Alright.
Stay safe out there.
Alright, I'll just keep Temet as is, and I will pick up our next mission.
We have a problem at Babel. Cordon rebels have taken several Federation trade officials hostage, and they're threatening to kill them unless the UFP withdraws from the Cordon sector. I'd like you to work with the negotiation team and try to resolve this peacefully.
Peacefully would be good. I'm a little bit tired of shooting at things, actually. Alright, and then we could get another tactical officer, it looks like. But we'll cross that road when it comes. I will accept the mission. And at this point, I'll say thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did enjoy this video, please do press like. Oops.
I need to speak with you in my quarters.
Bad timing, Daniels.
Time for that explanation, I owe you.
Alright, I'll be there shortly. Okay.
There's more to this mission than you realize, Captain.
Does Daniels know he's interrupting my outro here?
Alright. Something's not right. I'll explain shortly.
Okay. Are you done yet, Daniels? Yes? Alright. Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did enjoy this video, please do press like. If you have any comments or questions, please leave them in the comment section below. And I'll see you next time.